All right. The man of the moment and the man of the year, Stewart Hagestad, U.S. mid-am champ, Masters low-am, and now you're headed to your first U.S. Open. What is going through your mind?
I don't know about man of the year. I'll take man of the moment. That's good enough for me. But no, it's a dream come true. The USGA puts on just such an elite golf tournament anytime, you know, you get the chance to play in a USGA event. So it's a dream come true for me. Obviously, you know, it's the second major of the year. But as far as... I'd love another beer. But it's a dream come true. You know, it's our national championship for a reason. And to go out there and test my game against the world's best on what's, I'm sure, to be a very challenging golf course, it's just another opportunity to try and learn a little bit more about my game and to try and get a little bit better. So I'll prepare the best way I know how and, you know, hopefully go out there. And I'm sure some friends and family will come. But, no, it's a dream come true for me.
What you've already been through this year in some high-pressure situations, how does that better prepare you for next week at Erin Hills?
It definitely doesn't hurt. It's difficult to kind of impress upon people just really how much the crowd makes, you know, a difference. The most nervous day I've probably ever had playing golf was the Tuesday and Wednesday before the Masters started. Obviously, when Thursday, you know, started, it was huge. But I kind of got into my own space and, you know, was able to kind of put the blinders on, and I'm sure that's what will happen again, but it definitely helps because I have a little bit better idea of what to expect. And I know, and I'm sure I'll be nervous, but at the same time, you know, just kind of understanding what that's like, you know, it kind of allows you to mentally prepare for it. And you know, hopefully we can take what we learned at the Masters and, you know, kind of make the most of it, you know, at the U.S. Open.
Before we let you go, we have to talk about Big Canyon Country Club. You did this in front of your home club. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, it's my baby. I love this place, and it's home, and it always will be home. It's where I grew up. I've spent a lot of time on that putting green, the one on 10, that chipping green, and the range. So I don't even really think it's an argument as far as people that know the golf course better than me. And you know, it was great to have the support and the people that were out there. You know, just everyone I've grown up around, as far as just, you know, friends and I guess you could say fans, not so much, but just, you know, family. And it's a dream come true to have their support. But at the same time, there's also a little bit of maybe home course disadvantage. So as I mentioned earlier about the U.S. Open, I kind of just tried to put the blinders on and just tried to really dumb it down as far as golf goes. You know, small targets, committed golf swings, try and hit fairways and greens and some stress-free birdie looks. And I did a really nice job of that. But at the same time, you know, having experience definitely helps, but you still got to go out and play. So I played a great round this afternoon. I'm really, really proud of that. So, it's been a good day.